Excellency, my friend Sumaya, I'm so happy to see you here. I don't know why, she was one of the first persons that I met when I came here to Sudan 2 years ago, and I had the impression of immediately of the image of a bright Sudan when we reach highest level in terms of education and I would say long-minded vision as Sumaya has. My friends of Comboni, every time I come here, I have to say that I feel moved and happy, not only because we're talking about some kind of Italian-style entity, but most of all because I think that here I can find every time I enter these doors the real meaning and the real essence of Sudan. When you arrive at the airport of Khartoum, at a certain moment, one of the most important cartoons that you have in front of you at the wall is Sudan, country of magic diversity. It's exactly that that I mean. In this place, all over Sudan, I can feel, I can smell this diversity. And I can feel that this diversity here is a richness. Here, diversity doesn't build walls. Here, diversity is a continual exchange. It means tolerance, dialogue, understanding, patience, resilience, professionality. And this kind of character that I find it here in Comboni is something that is possible because Sudan is deeply in this intercultural dimension. Even if sometimes even Sudan itself doesn't know how much intercultural and how much in terms of dialogues and tolerance it can express towards the other. When I came here, I immediately found that I'm a sensitive person, so I catched this character. But again, if we see education in intercultural terms, through intercultural lens, you can see education as a mix of giving, but also empowering. And only an attentive observer of the situation here in Sudan can find this mix of giving and empowering and making a sort of fine-tuning of our diplomatic offer to Sudan in accordance to what Sudan needs from us, what Sudan wants from Italy, what Sudan needs in this moment. It would be too easy to come here and to say, okay, I give a very superficial sight and I decided what kind of education I give, what kind of subject I decided to do. I'm good in this and then I export this to Sudan. This is a mistake. This is a multicultural approach. It's not intercultural approach. Intercultural approach is coming here, humbly, looking around, talk to people, observing institutions, observing the state, the people, civil society, men, women, elder people, everybody, and afterwards making some kind of judgments. They are not pre-judgments, they are not pre-jurists. It's a way of interpret our diplomacy, trying to encountering the desire of Sudan. Education is very important. I remember last year we had a quarrel with a country of European Union, I wouldn't mention who, in terms of development cooperation, because we were trying to decide what to do in the eastern part of Sudan with the project in particular, and they were completely idealistically fixed on the term empowerment. We have to let people of Sudan doing everything by themselves, excluding the state, excluding the institutions. Wrong. They didn't see they hadn't seen the reality. In Sudan, a lot is institutional, a lot is a state. This is a process. It's a process of institution, of democracy. It's a process of history. It's a process of evolution. So, the capacity of an intercultural diplomatic action is to make a fine-tuning with this kind of character and then countering our offer to Sudan. In this case, our offer is a mix. We give and we empower. We give and after we empower. We empower and sometimes we give, because Sudan needs both. And this is development cooperation in politics, in culture, and in education, in health, in agriculture, in every kind of sector. I found this fantastic mix. And who better than Italians, Italian institutions? But in this way, it's friend to friend, people to people, professional to professional, student to student. No matter religion, no matter ethnicity, anything.
This project made a couple of telephone calls to Rome with the Ministry of Interior in order to say, you know, if you want to give some money, you are giving to the best people the money that you would like to invest in Sudan. So probably they also heard about our voice, because we didn't do anything, but we are ready, we are here to do whatever it is needed in order to take this project and to make it fly for a long time and to have the maximum of all the results that you may need to make it grow places like this, because only the tolerance and the dialogue that we have established with Sudan allows places like Comboni doing the fantastic and excellent job that we do. And we as institutions are here to thank, to testify this, to be from your part, by your part, and to say whatever you need, we are here to help. Thank you.